My name is Mike Rizzo. I'm a principal solutions architect based in London in the UK, and I work in the telecoms industry business unit at AWS. What I'm going to show you here today is a few demos related to the problem of content discovery and subscription management control. These are essential features that anyone who's offering a TV service as part of their telco offering to their customers needs to give careful consideration to. Pay TV has changed a lot in recent years. It used to be the case that there was a simple model where subscribers came and bought a package of channels from a telco operator, and everything was managed centrally in one place. But things have changed now, and we have all these apps. We've got Netflix, Prime Video, Disney, right? And subscribers are now subscribing to all these apps individually, resulting in fragmentation of the content discovery and management process. So in this demo, what we're looking at is ways that telecom operators can help customers to improve the way they discover content and the way they manage their subscriptions, the way they control access to their subscriptions. The content discovery problem is related to the fact that now the data that is used for search, for recommendations, right, is essentially spread across multiple applications. So what can we do as a telco operator to make it easier for customers to find the content that they want? And secondly, the control problem is the fact that because there are all these different things customers need to subscribe to, it puts more work and more effort on subscribers to keep track of that. One of our customers, Optus in Australia, reported that 20% of their customers had more than 10 subscriptions, and many of them were feeling overwhelmed by this. They coined the term subscription fatigue as a name for this problem of having to deal with all these subscriptions. They even found a lot of customers had subscriptions that they didn't even know they had and weren't using, and they were paying for them for nothing. Let's start with discovery. So if you want to build solutions for content discovery, you need rich metadata. The more metadata you have, the better, right? The more options you have in terms of being able to find stuff. For some time now, we've had the concept of a media lake, where you can bring video into the cloud and run tools to do all sorts of things with that video. You can extract transcripts and maybe translate them into other languages. You can look for certain objects or certain faces in the video and create metadata out of that. And you can also do things like sentiment detection to figure out, you know, different sections of a video, are they, what sort of type of mood do they correspond with? With generative AI, we can now take this a step further. We can actually use metadata we extract out of the video in order to generate new content. So take, for example, a situation where you might want to promote a particular episode of a series, which, you know, a customer has watched traditionally, but for some reason they've missed the last episode, and you want to have them come up to speed on the latest on that series. You can use a video summarization solution to take the latest episode, summarize it, and send that to the user to prompt them to come back to watch that TV series. So in our first demo, I'm just going to show you a solution that we built where you can take a video, upload a video, and then create a summary with a voiceover. So you have a narrator with a voiceover explaining what happened in that video. With this solution, you can choose your narrator's voice, you can choose a male or female, and within that you have multiple voices that you can choose from. We will also be adding multi-language support to this as well. And basically you submit this task and off it goes, and we'll create a summary video for you. Here's one it did earlier. This is a video that was 12 minutes, being summarized down to 1 minute 22. So I'd like to play you an example summary video that we created with this solution. And the key thing to watch for here is that when you create a video summary, you need to make sure that the narration, the script for the narrator, right, is aligned with what you're seeing on the screen. So you need to extract the right video clips from the right places and tie them to what is actually being said in the summary. I'll run this for a while so that you can see this in action. This is a summary video of the Rose Parade, coverage of the Rose Parade. You can see that when, for example, the narrator is talking about the float for the carnival. You're actually seeing the float for the carnival. The United States Marine Corps mounted officer on horseback is being shown when the narrator is talking about it. Same for the band, etc. So the way this works is using a generative AI large language model. Essentially, what we're doing here is we're taking the original video, extracting a transcript of the audio, giving that to a large language model, and saying to the large language model, create a summary of this that the narrator can use. But also, crucially, for each sentence that you generate, also record the timestamp of the original video to link it back to where in the original video it actually came from, right? And in that way, the output from the LLM allows you to do two things. It allows you to then create a voice summary from the summarized transcript for the new video. It also has the right timestamps that allow you to go back to the original video and extract video clips, which you can then stitch together and tie in with the new audio track to assemble the new video. That's an example of how you can use generative AI to create new content. Another example of what you can do with generative AI as part of the content discovery experience. So this is an example from one of our partners, Think Analytics. Think Analytics are a specialist in personalized recommendations for TV. They traditionally have worked in the way we've all come to expect, that on the screen you will see a horizontal carousel with things that are recommended for you. Now this is very much based on the user's viewing history. So based on things that users have watched in the past, it will come up with suggestions. But sometimes users might be in a different contextual situation. They might be sitting down with someone else who wants to watch something different. They might be in the mood for something different. In this example, this user was in the mood for watching a comedy. They didn't want to watch any of the things suggested to them. They wanted to watch something else. So Think Analytics have added this chatbot, right? And with this chatbot, you are able to engage, to interact, and ask for things, right? So here we've asked to watch a comedy. It's come back and suggested a comedy on Apple TV. This particular user doesn't have Apple TV, so they've said, okay, show me something on Netflix. And it's come back and shown a suggestion for Netflix. This potentially could be done with voice. We're showing this with text here, but it could easily be done with a voice solution as well. And now the last thing I'd like to show you is the control aspect. So we've looked at discovery. Now let's come to the problem of how to manage all these subscriptions. And I'll come back to our customer Optus in Australia and the way they dealt with this. Optus created a solution called SubHub, Subscription Hub. And basically they offer this to all their mobile subscribers. With SubHub, mobile subscribers can go in and subscribe to a range of very popular services, Netflix, Prime, NBA League Pass, not just video though, even things like Microsoft 365, TikTok Music, GeForce Now, right? It's a place where in one one-stop shop, they can subscribe or unsubscribe to various services. All the billing is handled centrally so that all the bills for all these services appear on the Optus bill. So in one place, you can see how much you're spending on subscriptions and which subscriptions you're actually spending money on. And on top of that, Optus offer promotional offers on all these services and also offer a discount. The more subscriptions you take, the more discount you get. This makes it very attractive for the customers to subscribe through this, and it therefore creates stickiness for the mobile service. And Optus have reported that for those who use the subscription hub heavily, they've seen a 30% reduction in churn. So we've seen a few ways here on how telco operators can use solutions built on AWS in order to improve the customer experience for their customers in a world where pay TV is fragmented across multiple applications. And we've also seen how we can improve the subscription management experience in a way that benefits both customers, but also operators, because by offering a better customer experience to their customers, operators are able to increase stickiness for their services. Thank you for watching. I hope you found that interesting. Thank you.